useful for us. So there are mainly four types of programmable logic devices, which are PLA, which is the programmable logic array. Then we have PAL, which is programmable array logic. Then we have CPLD, which is complex logic devices. And finally, we have FPGA. So now first we discuss about PLA, which is programmable logic array. So in this, what happens is that we have an array of AND gates and OR gates in which both are programmable. So we can understand that using this example where we have the equation y1 is equal to A B bar C bar plus A B bar C plus A B C. Then we have another equation y2 A bar B C plus A B bar C plus A B C. So basically what these are Boolean equations, and using PLA, we are going to design, we are going to get a circuit for these two equations and in such a way that they can be reconfigurable or reprogrammed. So first we have to minimize this sum of products. We are seeing this as sum of products because each term is a product and they are sum. So these equations we call as sum of products, which is shorted as SOP. So first for y1, we have to minimize it. We do in this format with symbol. So to minimize this, we will use a Boolean law which states that when a variable is added to itself, for example, if we have a variable A, when we add that the same variable to itself, we get the same variable. So using this law, what we can do is that we can minimize this as we will take A B bar C twice. Now from this, in these two equations we can see that A B bar is common. So we will take A B bar common, then we will get C plus C bar. Here also we will get AC as common, so we will get AC into B bar plus B. So one more Boolean law states that when we add variables complement to itself, which means A plus A bar, then we will get 1. So here we can see that there is C plus C bar, this value will be 1. Again B plus B bar will also be 1. So now we get any variable which is multiplied by 1 will get the same variable. So here we will get A B bar plus A C. So this can be minimized into A B bar plus A C. Now for the second equation. For y2, we have the equation A bar B C plus A B bar C plus A B C. Here also we will be using the same Boolean laws. So here we will take A B C again, which is like this, A bar B C plus A B bar C plus A B C. So here we can take A bar from these two common. Sorry, we can take BC common. Then we will get A bar plus A. And from these two, we can take AC common. Again, using the similar Boolean law, we will get BC plus AC. Here we will get BC plus AC. So as I already told, programmable logic array has an array of AND and OR gates which are both programmable. So how we will design is that first we have to decide the number of buffers for each input. We have to decide the number of AND gates and also the number of OR gates. So since we have A, B, C as the inputs, we will take 3 buffers. So here a buffer, we will get from one buffer each the similar A and its complement. It will be like this. This will be a buffer, and whatever input we give, we'll get the same output, and again we'll also get the complement. So since we have three inputs like that, we'll take three buffers. Now coming to the number of AND gates. Here we can see that for Y1 and Y2 together, we have four midterms: A, B bar, A, C, B, C, and A, C. But in Y1 and Y2, A, C is repeated. So we can consider the number of midterms to be 3. Bar B, bar C plus A B bar C. So for PA, we have to consider the maximum number of minterms, which is 3. Since we have 3 minterms, each input, that is A will get 3 AND gates, B will get 3 AND gates, and C will also get 3 AND gates. And for output, since we have, for OR gates, since we have 3 outputs, we will get 3 OR gates. So now let's see how that is. Buffers will be the same. Now, as I have already told, the number of AND gates will be total 9, that is 3 for each, 3 into 3 will be 9. And the number of OR gates will be 3. So first we will fix our OR gates. This is one OR gate. Then A, C. So this will be A bar B and this will be A C. Here we can see that for X there is no another main term. So what we will do is that we will fuse it, which means that it will not be connected to the AND. Similarly for Y, we will take A bar B bar. A bar B, A bar C, and A B bar C. So here we can see these dots which I have already put. This is fixed here and these cannot be recomputed. This is how a programmable array logic will be designed. So now this is one of the most used programmable logic devices of when compared to a programmable logic. Now we'll see what are CPLUs. So CPLUs are basically complex logic devices. So they can accommodate up to 10,000 devices in one circuit. So the basic point, and apart from that we also have